Thanks for the technology for bringing us closer in spite of COVID-19. To our Almighty God for protecting us and our loved ones against the coronavirus. To our proud parents, faculty members, visitors, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, good day. Maybe you are asking why I am here. Even myself asked the same thing. The time I received a message from Ma'am Crescencio Teresa Cloda asking me to be your guest speaker, my response was, "Nick, kadlo. I'm not into this kind of stuff, doing a public talk. Some part of me saying I cannot do it, but in some point, I think I need to tell you my story." At this moment, maybe some of you are my follower on Facebook due to my virtual dance contest, which just started 1st June and will end 16th of August, my birthday. Kinigiligiliwan ko na kasi mag-share ng blessing, especially na pagpalapit na yung birthday ko. Lalo na ngayon, pandemic, some of us has lost courage. It's my way to give entertainment and encouragement para makalimutan kadali ang mga worries sa ating pandemya karon. Before we go to that sharing of blessing, I would love to share with you who I was when I was at your age. Kuya Anton, katong elementary pa ko, was simple guy. I go to school without a single penny in my hand. I go to school na dili pare sa akong chinelas. I only have one pair of uniform. My dad, during my school days, was an alcoholic. I was bullied by my classmate kang Papa Palahubog. I was bullied kay gamay kayo kung niya alam niya pagyud ko. I was bullied kay wala kay baon. Some of you might say, "We, di nga." But yeah, that's Kuya Anton during my childhood days. I did not finish my elementary with a high honor. Special award lang okay na po. I was being motivated to study and get a high honor when I am in high school with the help and guiding love of my mom. Muang kinggid ko na ambisyoso ko na pagkatao. Bata pa lang ko gusto na kumatuog ng Amerika kay mo tama po snow. Natigulang na lang ko, wala gapon ko katuog Amerika. But take note, I've been to Europe and many countries in Asia. And now, I am here in Singapore making dollars. Walay kumo sa mga vision of dako. That would be your goal to reach and fulfill your dreams. Since grade 1 to grade 6, I always step up on that stage to receive my special award, Singer of the Year. I remember Boy Scout ko atong time, ako ang advisor si Ma'am Kabutahi. Ako ang panlaban sa singing contest sa Maniki. Daghan school nag-compete. Ang ako mga kalaban, wow, bukoy tingog. Pag sadihang ako na nagkanta, pop! Regen Velasquez. Og sadihang naka-place food ko. Every singing contest sa school nag-appeal cute ko. Now, you are at this level para mag-uplift sa yourself. Next, high school days. Crushes, okay rin na. Ayaw lang pag-uyab-uyab. Kay bata pa man mo. Finish your study first. Be professional like me and your teacher. Accomplish your dream and be successful in life. I would consider myself as a successful. Dili dato, kay awas magkukwarta. Liwat ko sa ako ang papa, ang hatag diri, hatag po dito. Even his own clothes, iyang hubuon pag naay mga natitibo o di kaya isaya. That's me. I'm willing to give as long as I know that they really need it. O kung naalang po kay kwarta. High school days, that's the time na nag-sit up na ko sa ako ang goal. Naglanto na ako sa ako ang future. Now at this point, graduates, ask yourself, 10 to 12 years from now, what kind of life you wanted to have? Who are you at that time? And while you're on that process, make an action to fulfill that dream. That time, I wanted to be in line with medicine. Because that time also my eldest sister, whom now a district manager in a big drug company, the Mercury Drug, is already a pharmacist. And my other sister also took a nursing course. So at that point, I wanted to become a doctor. I finished my high school with a high honor and took an entrance exam at UCEP for BS Biology. But sad to say, dili day anak ko kautukan. Kaya nga average na ako nakuha, dili pang BS Biology. So that time, I was upset. My mom gave me another option. So at that time, nakainan ko, if dili ko pwede mag-doctor, mag-lawyer na lang ko. Ingon anak, di ko pagkabisyuso. But at some point also, my elder brother took mechanical engineering. So ako, nagtok na lang po kong civil engineering para lakas makamacho. I finished my civil engineering by God's grace and with the help of my parent and with the help of my dad's company, KMS Farming Corporation, which is really a big help. Nakalampas nito lang. Now, your Kuya Anton working in Singapore for 14 years as a design engineer in a railway, world-class railway project in Singapore. Now, your Kuya Anton is successful. I am eligible. I have my own house. I have my own car. I have a small business. And now, trying to share my blessings, and I hope I can share my blessings not only sa atong lugar, kundi pati na sa mga nitibo sa bukid. I hope by sharing this little experience, I can inspire you and motivate you that poverty, even COVID-19, is not a hindrance to be a successful. That's all. Thank you.